यस बेटा, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पेज 33 वेयर वी हैव सीन दैट नाउ डॉक्टर सेडो हैज स्टार्टेड द प्रेपरेशंस फॉर मेकिंग द ऑपरेशन और डूइंग ऑपरेशन ऑन दैट प्रिजनर ऑफ वॉर बिकॉज ही वॉन्टेड टू सेव हिम बाय ऑल मीन्स. सो He only wanted to have his full attention on the patient. So he was not listening to Henna, what she was telling. She wanted to complain about Yumi. And we are going to start from page 33 when she said, if it mattered to him, what was the body upon which he worked so long, as it was the work he did so excellently, because he was working on the body of that patient, of that American prisoner of war, and now he was not paying any attention to anyone because his only purpose was just to save the life of that man. You will have to give the anesthetic if he needs it, he said. Now see, all type of help of an assistant he's taking from Henna. Whatever he is telling, Henna is doing it obediently and in a very good manner just to help the doctor. That shows her kind and sympathetic nature, that she was very generous in this way. And on the humanitarian ground, she also understands that they have to save the life of the operation, because as a doctor it becomes her husband's first and foremost duty to pay attention to the patient. So when Dr. Sedo told her that you will have to give the anesthetic if he needs it, he said, she repeated blankly, but never have I. She got surprised because she had never done it earlier. So she was surprised and she asked that I have to do it. It is easy enough, he said impatiently. He was taking out the packing now and he told her that it is very easy, and he was unpacking that packing which he had already done just to stop the bleeding, and the blood began to flow more quickly. He peered into the wound with the bright surgeon's light percent on his forehead. Usne apne forehead ke upar light lagayi hai, jaise operation ke time doctors lagate hain, surgeon अपने फोरहेड के ऊपर एक लाइट सी लगा लेते हैं, सो दैट दे कैन सी द इजी थिंग्स इजीली. एंड ही पीयर्ड इनटू द वुंड, पीयर्ड इन हिज लुक्ड इनटू, उस जख्म के अंदर वो देख रहा है अपने ब्राइट सर्जन लाइट के साथ. एंड द बुलेट इज स्टिल देयर, व्हाट ही नोटिस्ड दैट बुलेट वाज स्टिल देयर, ही सेड विद कूल इंटरेस्ट, नाउ आई वंडर हाउ डीप दिस रॉक वुंड इज. नाउ ही वाज टेलिंग हेना दैट ही वाज वंडरिंग how deep this wound was which she had got with the striking of the rocks. If it is not too deep, it may be that I can get the bullet. This is if the wound is not too deep, agar jakham bahut gehra nahi hota to shayad wo bullet ko aasani se nikal sakta tha, but the bleeding is not superficial. But according to him, bleeding is not superficial, that means it is coming from inside. ऊपर ऊपर से नहीं है, अंदर से ब्लड जो है वो अभी भी निकल रहा है. ही हैज लॉस्ट मच ब्लड एंड ही हैज लॉस्ट टू मच ब्लड नाउ, सो वाज बिकमिंग वीक, दैट्स व्हाई ही वाज अनकॉन्शियस आल्सो एट दिस मोमेंट. हेना चोक्ड, ही लुक्ड अप एंड सॉ हर फेस द कलर ऑफ सल्फर. नाउ सी द कंडीशन ऑफ दिस लेडी हेना, शी हैड नेवर सीन ऑपरेशन इन फ्रंट ऑफ हर आईज बिफोर दिस. So she also got very nervous and frightened and felt choking. Usko aise laga ki uske apne gale mein koi problem usko feel ho rahi hai. He looked up and saw her face, the color of sulfur. Jaise usne upar dekha, to uska face jo tha puri tarah se dull hua pada tha sulfur ke color ki tarah. Don't faint, he said sharply. He did not put down his exploring instrument, and Dr. Sedo noted this thing. That Henna was not feeling well, she was feeling choked or suffocated, and he just told her, "Don't faint." He did not put down his exploring instrument. जिस instrument से वो काम कर रहा था, उसने वो instrument अपना जो था उसको side पे नहीं रखा. He did not leave it, put down means usko choda nahi. He kept on doing his work. If I stop now, the man will surely die. क्योंकि उसको क्या डर था कि अगर वो अपने इस instrument को छोड़ता है तो man will surely die. So in this way, he kept on doing his work and he did not stop his work. But he was suggesting henna that she should not faint as that would cause problem. So Dr. Sadow said, don't faint, he said sharply. He did not put down his exploring instrument. If I stop now, the man will surely die. She clapped her hands to her mouth and leaped up and ran out of the room. What she did, because she felt just like vomiting. So she just clapped her hands on her mouth and leaped up, means jumped up and ran out of the room. Room se bahar bhag kar chale jaati hai so that she should not have vomiting there, because she was feeling very suffocated. She had never seen operation in front of her eyes. Outside in the garden, he heard her retching. Retching means just the sound of vomiting. When she went outside, Dr. Sadow was hearing that she was vomiting outside, but he went on with his work. But see the sincerity of his work, that though his wife was in problem, but he did not go out to see her. He kept on doing his own work, that was operating upon the patient. Wo patient ka operation mein jo apna kaam mein busy tha, he was busy there. He heard the voice of her vomiting, but he did not go out. It will be better for her to empty her stomach, he thought. Aur kya soch raha hai ki it would be better if she emptied her stomach and she could bear this operation. He had forgotten that, of course, she had never seen an operation, because he did not remember this thing. He had forgotten this, that she had never seen an operation. But her distress and his inability to go to her at once made him impatient and irritable with this man who lay like dead under his knife. See his feelings and his attitude. Though he is working on the operation, he is working with the patient, but he felt distressed and sad because he wanted to go out and help his wife in this condition when she was vomiting. But her distress and his inability to go to her at once made him impatient. He suddenly became impatient because he wanted to go out and help his wife, and irritable, felt irritated also with this man who was laying on the bed under his knife. That means being operated and being cut his body for the operation by the doctor, but he could not go because his duty as a doctor was foremost for him. Though he did not want to operate him, though he did not have any good feelings for him, he considers him as his enemy, but still he kept on working on the operation because that was the sincerity and the professional duty. This man, he thought, there is no reason under heaven why he should live. And see the feelings, as Henna was telling, that this man should not live. The gardener, their old servant, was also telling, this man should not live. Ki is aadmi ko zinda nahi rehna chahiye. The same feeling is coming in his mind also. He says, this man, there is no reason under heaven why he should live. Kisi bhi tarike se is aadmi ko zinda nahi rehna chahiye, because he was their bitter enemy. Unconsciously, this thought made him ruthless and he proceeded swiftly, though he was proceeding with his work swiftly, but unconsciously he became harsh. Ruthless means he became harsh with this thought. Jaise hi uske mind mein ye thought aata hai ki uska jo patient hai wo uska enemy hai, chahe ki wo operation ke apne kaam ko continue rakhta hai, but still he became harsh. In his dream, the man moaned. But Sedo paid no heed except to mutter at him. Or in his dream, the man moaned कि आदमी जो कि बेड के ऊपर लेटा हुआ है, जिसका ऑपरेशन चल रहा है, American prisoner of war, though he was crying, moaning means he was crying in his dream, ऐसे लग रहा था unconscious, वो कोई dream देख रहा है और उसमें चिल्ला रहा है. But Sedo paid no heed means no attention except to mutter at him. Just he was muttering in his own voice in the slow volume. He was talking to himself. वो अपने आप से बातें कर रहा है, but he does not pay any attention to the crying of that man. Groan, he muttered. Groan, if you like. I'm not doing this for my own pleasure. In fact, I do not know why I am doing it. See his inner feelings, the conflict in his mind. On the one side, he is performing his duty as a doctor, doing the operation. On the other side, he is taking him as a bitter enemy. और जैसे हम अपने दुश्मन को कहते हैं ना, या किसी से कोई बदला लेना होता है, उसको कहते हैं चिल्लाओ और आपको मजा आ रहा होता है. In the same way, he is saying, he is muttering, he says, groan, groan means cry, ya aur chilao, groan, if you like. I am not doing this for my own pleasure. He says, I am not happy to do this operation. But in fact, why I am doing, I myself don't know. मतलब वो खुद ही उसको नहीं पता कि वो क्यों ऑपरेशन कर रहा है. Because it was the conscience of a doctor, which was compelling him to perform his duty sincerely. The door opened and there was Hina again. And Hina came inside again after the vomiting. Where is the anesthetic? She asked in a clear voice, because the doctor Sedo had told her that she had to give the anesthetic. What is anesthetic? It is a medicine to make the person unconscious. कि उसको pain जो है वो feel ना हो, उसको बेहोश करने के लिए जिस part का operate किया जाता है उस part के साथ ये है anesthetic दे दिया जाता है, so that that part should become numb. उसमें सुन हो जाए वो हिस्सा और जो भी पेशेंट है उसको पेन फील ना हो. तो दिस एनेस्थेटिक इज गिवन फॉर एवरी ऑपरेशन. किसी भी तरह का भी ऑपरेशन हो, एनेस्थेटिक का इंजेक्शन जो है, ये मेडिसिन अभी यहाँ चल रही है लेकिन आजकल इसके लिए इंजेक्शन जो है वो आ चुके हैं. सो द डॉक्टर वॉज टेलिंग हेना टू गिव दिस एनेस्थेटिक, मीन्स ये मेडिसिन दे ताकि वो बेहोश हो जाए और उसको पेन जो है वो फील ना हो. इट इज compulsory to give before the operations. Sedo motioned with his chin. It is as well that you came back, he said. This fellow is beginning to stir. Or apne chin hilakar, motion means movement karke, wo ishara karke usko batata hai ki wahan par medicine padi hai, as if he wants to tell that it is good that she had come back. And even he told this thing also to Hina, that the fellow, this fellow refers to the prisoner of war, jiska ऑपरेशन हो रहा है पेशेंट का. He has started beginning to stir, कि उसने मूवमेंट स्टार्ट कर दिया है, उसने हिलना जुलना शुरू कर दिया है. सो एनेस्थेटिक एनेस्थीसिया जो है उसको देना जरूरी है, अदरवाइज ही वुड नॉट बी एबल टू बिकम अनकॉन्शियस एंड ही वुड फील पेन. शी हैड द बॉटल एंड सम कॉटन इन हर हैंड. उसके हाथ में बॉटल है एनेस्थीसिया की और कॉटन है, बट शी डज नॉट नो हाउ टू गिव इट. But how shall I do it? She asked. So she asked the method to give this medicine. Simply saturate the cotton and hold it near his nostril. Sedo replied without delaying for one moment the intricate detail of his work. कि उसके काम का जो intricate details थी, intricate means बहुत गुंजलदार, complex, जो कि easy नहीं था, उस काम को वो कर रहा है ऑपरेशन को, क्योंकि उसको बुलेट निकालनी है, फिर उस जख्म को भरना भी है. He just told Hina that she should simply saturate the cotton. Saturate the cotton means she should soak the cotton in that bottle of anesthesia medicine and hold it near his nostril. Aur uske nostril, uske naak ke paas rakhe. Ki us cotton ko sirf us medicine mein dip kar le, usko gilla kare, soak kare aur uske nose ke paas rakh de. Wo usko smell karega to wo unconscious ho jayega. This was the earlier method. Nowadays injection is there. And mostly the doctors give injection before any type of operation. किसी भी तरह का operation हो तो उसके लिए, अगर lower part का है तो lower part को numb कर दिया जाता है, upper part भी हो तो upper part को numb कर दिया जाता है. In this way, anesthesia injection is given. But at that time when the story was written, they used to give this type of anesthesia, that it was only through the smell that the patient would get unconscious. She had the bottle and some cotton, so she listened Dr. Sedo carefully. when he breathes badly, move it away a little. कि जब वो बहुत जोर से सांस लेगा, मतलब जैसे ही उसको स्मेल जाएगी तो वो बहुत बैडली तेजी से स्मेल लेगा, तो तब आप इस कॉटन को पीछे कर लेना. ही जस्ट गाइडेड है ना. शी क्राउच्ड क्लोज टू द स्लीपिंग फेस ऑफ द यंग अमेरिकन. इट वॉज अ पिटियस थिन फेस, शी थॉट, एंड द लिप्स वर ट्विस्टेड व्हेन शी स्टार्टेड गिविंग दिस सैचुरेटेड सोक्ड कॉटन इन फ्रंट ऑफ हर नॉस्ट्रिल. She just looked at his face. उसके face को देखती है और उसकी personality के बारे में हमें explain करती है. She crouched close to the sleeping face of the young American. उस young American के sleeping face के पास वो पहुंच जाती है. It was a piteously thin face, she thought, and the lips were twisted. The man was suffering, whether he knew it or not. चाहे उसको होश थी या नहीं थी, but they were understanding this thing that he was in pain, he was suffering. Watching him, she wondered if the stories they heard sometimes of the sufferings of prisoners of were true. Now see, she goes into the background. When they were in America, Dr. Sedow and Hannah, they were in America for their education, and she remembered that time they used to listen some stories of the prisoners of war who were treated badly by the authorities of those that country of America. So she just started remembering. She says, watching him, she wondered if the stories they heard sometimes of the sufferings of prisoners were true. कि क्या उस time जो stories सुना करते थे prisoners की sufferings के बारे में, क्या वो सच थी stories? They came like flickers of rumor told by word of mouth and always contradicted. क्योंकि जब वो वहाँ थे तो वो stories सुना करते थे and they thought that these were the just the flickers of rumor, कि सिर्फ झूठी अफवाहें हैं, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता. Told by word of mouth, कोई ना कोई उनको अपने मुंह से ये स्टोरी सुनाता, and that story was always contradicted. Contradictory means that was not accepted. कि वो उसके विरोध में बात करते, उसके अपोजिट जाते कि ये सच नहीं हो सकता. कि जैसे ये लोग प्रिजनर्स की सफरिंग्स के बारे में सुना करते थे वहां पर जब थे अमेरिका में, स्टोरी सुनते थे तो इनको लगता था ये र्यूमर्स थी, लोग ऐसे ही एक मुंह से आगे बात दूसरे मुंह में चली जाती है तो बातें बन रही हैं या स्टोरीज बन रही हैं, र्यूमर्स बन रही हैं. इट वॉज नॉट एक्सेप्टेड, इट वॉज कॉन्ट्राडिक्टेड, मीन्स उसका विरोध किया जाता था, क्रिटिसाइज किया जाता था उसको कि ऐसा नहीं हो सकता. इन द न्यूज पेपर्स द रिपोर्ट्स वर ऑलवेज दैट वेयर एवर द जैपनीज आर्मीज वेंट द पीपल रिसीव देम ग्लैडली with cries of joy at their liberation. And in the newspapers, they were reading the reports that wherever the Japanese armies went, the people were receiving them gladly in a happy way, crying and shouting at their liberation. Japanese were becoming free and people were welcoming them after this war. But sometimes she remembered such men as General Takeima, underline this name, and don't get confused with the general that was in Japan for whom Dr. Sedow was doing the treatment. Jisko koi heart ki problem thi, beginning mein reference di gayi hai. There was general in Japan jiska ki Dr. Sedow treatment kar rahe the. He was suffering from some heart problem and he might have operation any time. So Dr. Sedow was not allowed to go with the army, with the troops. That's why he was allowed, he was made to stay in Japan. So in this way, yes beta, so in this way now Dr. Sedow, who was doing the operation, and when Hannah gave anesthesia, she just remembered the past when they were in America and what type of news and the rumors they were listening, but they don't believe on these things, that such type of things can happen. सो वॉट शी इज मेकिंग रेफरेंस हियर टू जनरल टेकीमा, कि वहां पर जब वो थे तो वहां पर एक जनरल था, जैसे हमारे यहाँ पर हेड होते ना आर्मीज में, इन द सेम वे दे वर हैविंग देयर हेड ऑफ द आर्मी देयर व्हिच वाज कॉल्ड एज जनरल, हु एट होम बीट हिज वाइफ क्रूअली, दैट नो वन मेंशनड इट नाउ दैट ही हैड फॉट सो विक्टोरियस अ बैटल इन मंचूरिया. एंड दे यूज्ड टू लिसन दीस टाइप ऑफ स्टोरीज दैट जनरल टेकीमा ही ऑलवेज बीट हिज वाइफ क्रूअली, दैट नो वन मेंशनड इट नाउ दैट ही हैड फॉट सो विक्टोरियस. और किसी ने ये मेंशन नहीं करा कि वो लड़ाई में बहुत अच्छे तरीके से फाइट करता था और मंचूरिया की बैटल जो था उसकी वजह से विक्टोरियस हुए थे वहां पर, वो कि उसकी वजह से वो इस बैटल को जीत पाए थे. दैट मींस ही वाज अ गुड वॉरियर, ही फॉट द बैटल्स इन अ गुड वे, वेरी ब्रेव सोल्जर, बट ही यूज्ड टू बीट हिज वाइफ एट होम वेरी क्रूअली, मींस वेरी हार्श एट होम. इफ अ मैन लाइक दैट कुड बी सो क्रूअल टू अ वुमन इन हिज पावर, वुड ही नॉट बी क्रूअल टू वन लाइक दिस फॉर इंस्टेंस. She just imagines the idea. उसकी ये example देकर वो imagine कर रही है कि अगर ऐसा आदमी जो कि बहुत brave warrior था, वो अपनी wife के साथ इतना cruel हो सकता है. वो power में था क्योंकि वो general था. अगर वो अपनी wife के साथ इतना cruel हो सकता है, तो क्या वो जो ऐसे लोग हैं जो prisoner of war हैं, जिनको कि उन्होंने कैदी बनाना है या उनके opposite country के हैं, क्या उनके साथ cruel नहीं होगा? Quite natural that he might be cruel to others. अगर वो नेचर से क्रूअल था, अपनी वाइफ को पीट सकता है, अपनी वाइफ को मारता था बहुत ज्यादा, चाहे कि वो एक ब्रेव सोल्जर था, लेकिन वो क्रूअल होगा, ऐसे लोगों के साथ भी क्रूअल होगा. सो शी इमेजिन्स द सिचुएशन ऑफ दिस मैन, इस आदमी की जो कि बेड के ऊपर लेटा हुआ है, वो उसकी सिचुएशन को समझने की कोशिश कर रही है कि वो कितनी ज्यादा परेशानी में होगा, कितना ज्यादा क्रूअल उसके साथ ट्रीटमेंट हुआ होगा कि वो वहां से उसने भागने की कोशिश करी जब उसको बुलेट लगी. She hoped anxiously that this young man had not been tortured. It was at this moment that she observed deep red scars on his neck just under the ear. Or she was hoping this thing very anxiously कि this man, young man had not been tortured. कि शायद इस आदमी ने वो टॉर्चर सहन नहीं करी होगी, because he tried to run away. He tried to escape from that place. वहां से भागने की कोशिश करी इसने, ये भाग कर निकल पड़ा वहां से, बचकर निकल आया है, और उन्होंने इसका पीछा किया और उसको गोली मारी होगी, लेकिन इसने टॉर्चर सहन नहीं करी होगी. She just imagines those scenes which they used to listen and read in the newspapers in those days when they were in America. It was at this moment that she observed. तभी क्या वो नोट करती है कि उसके नेक के ऊपर एक डीप रेड स्कार है, एक कट लगा हुआ है उसकी नेक के ऊपर, जस्ट अंडर द ईयर, उसके कान के नीचे गर्दन के ऊपर एक तरफ एक डीप रेड स्कार, मींस निशान था, जख्म का निशान था, जैसे कट था. दो स्कार्स, शी मर्मर्ड लिफ्टिंग हर आईज टू सेडो, एंड शी वांटेड टू आस्क फ्रॉम डॉक्टर सेडो अबाउट दैट स्कार, उन निशानों के बारे में, उस कट के बारे में वो डॉक्टर सेडो से डिस्कस करना चाहती है, बट ही डिड नॉट आंसर. बट ही वॉज बिजी इन हिज वर्क, he was busy in his operation, so he did not answer. At this moment he felt the tip of his instrument strike against something hard, kyunki doctor said us time kya feel kar rahe the ki wo apne jo uske haath mein instrument tha jisse wo bullet ko nikalna chahta tha, that was striking against something hard, usko lag raha tha kisi hard cheez se wo strike kar raha tha. That means he was very near to the bullet. Wo hard cheez kya thi, usko lag raha tha bullet hi thi, और वो अपना पूरा अटेंशन उस तरफ देना चाहता था, डेंजरसली नियर द किडनी. और इट वाज डेंजरस फॉर दैट मैन बिकॉज दैट बुलेट वाज नियर द किडनी. और अगर उसके हाथ में जो नाइफ या जो भी इंस्ट्रूमेंट था जिससे वो उस बुलेट को निकालना चाहता था उसके किडनी में लग जाता, तो दैट कुड हैव बीन डेंजरस. सो ही डज नॉट वॉन्ट टू डाइवर्ट हिज अटेंशन. वो अपना पूरा ध्यान उस अपने ऑपरेशन के काम की तरफ रखना चाहता था. सो ही डिड नॉट लिसन टू हैना व्हाट शी वांटेड टू आस्क. ऑल थॉट लेफ्ट हिम, ही फेल्ट ओनली द प्योरेस्ट प्लेयर. सारे विचार जो थे उसके माइंड से निकल जाते हैं. ही डिड नॉट थिंक एनीथिंग अबाउट दिस दैट ही वाज देयर एनिमी. वो बिल्कुल अपने मन से ये बात निकाल देता है जब ऑपरेट कर रहा है, और उसके माइंड में सिर्फ प्योरेस्ट प्लेयर था वो, प्योर जिसको कहते हैं हैप्पीनेस थी, खुशी थी, दैट ही वाज नियर दैट प्लेस वेयर द बुलेट वाज. और उस आदमी को बिल्कुल वो सेफ करने के पोजीशन में था कि अगर बुलेट निकल जाती है तो उसके बाद वो आदमी उसके अकॉर्डिंगली सेफ था. इट वाज ओनली डू दैट बुलेट व्हिच वाज इन हिज बॉडी. He probed with his fingers, delicately familiar with every atom of this human body. Note down this point now. He was very much familiar with the every atom. Atom means even the small particles of human body. So he tried to probe with his fingers. उसने अपनी उंगलियों के साथ delicately, बड़े आराम से उसके body के हर part को प्रोब करने की कोशिश करी, मतलब उसका इन्वेस्टिगेशन करने की कोशिश करी. हिज ओल्ड अमेरिकन प्रोफेसर ऑफ एनाटॉमी हैड सीन टू दैट नॉलेज. प्लीज अंडरलाइन दिस, फ्रॉम वेयर ही हैड गॉट दिस नॉलेज, हाउ टू ऑपरेट, हाउ टू बिकम अ सक्सेसफुल सर्जन. ही गिव्स द बैकग्राउंड स्टोरी ऑफ हिज एजुकेशन व्हेन ही वाज इन अमेरिका. हिज ओल्ड अमेरिकन प्रोफेसर ऑफ एनाटॉमी हैड सीन टू दैट नॉलेज, उसने ये सारी उसको नॉलेज दी थी. Ignorance, underline these points which are given in the inverted commas, that is the speech of his professor of anatomy. Ignorance of human body is the surgeon's cardinal sin. Sirs, he had thundered at his classes year after year. कि हर साल के बाद, मतलब जितनी देर भी वो उस एजुकेशन में रहे अपनी डॉक्टरी लाइन में, हर साल वो थंडर मींस गर्ज गर्ज कर उनको ये कहा करता था कि इग्नोरेंस ऑफ ह्यूमन बॉडी इज द सर्जन्स कार्डिनल सिन. कि अगर एक सर्जन को ह्यूमन बॉडी की नॉलेज नहीं है तो वो सर्जन का कार्डिनल सिन मींस वेरी सीरियस सिन है. सबसे बड़ा वो अपराध करने जा रहा है अगर वो ऑपरेट करेगा सर्जन और उसको ह्यूमन बॉडी की नॉलेज नहीं है. अगर उसको ह्यूमन बॉडी की नॉलेज है तब तो वो सक्सेसफुल हो सकता है. अगर उसको ह्यूमन बॉडी के हर पार्ट की नॉलेज नहीं है तो इट विल बी अ वेरी डेंजरस सिन, वेरी सीरियस सिन ही इज गोइंग टू कमिट, टू ऑपरेट विदाउट एज कंप्लीट नॉलेज ऑफ द बॉडी एज इफ यू हैड मेड इट. एनीथिंग लेस देन दैट इज मर्डर. And what he used to say, again the statement is in the inverted commas, the statement of the professor, कि अगर आप operate करना चाहते हो तो आपको human body की complete knowledge होनी चाहिए. Body के हर part की, atom means very small particle, छोटे से छोटा part जो भी body के अंदर है उसकी पूरी knowledge होनी चाहिए. Only then you can become a successful surgeon, as if you had made it. आपको इतनी knowledge होनी चाहिए जैसे कि आपने ही human body को बनाया हो. हर चीज की आपको नॉलेज होनी चाहिए. एनीथिंग लेस देन दैट इज मर्डर. और अगर आपको इतनी नॉलेज नहीं है, किसी भी चीज में थोड़ी भी कमी है आपकी नॉलेज में, तो इट वुड बी अ मर्डर, नॉट एन ऑपरेशन डन बाय द सर्जन. सो दिस वाज द नॉलेज एंड द एजुकेशन गिवन बाय द प्रोफेसर ऑफ एनाटॉमी, अमेरिकन प्रोफेसर ऑफ एनाटॉमी टू डॉक्टर सेडो. एंड ही रिमेंबर्ड हिज टीचिंग्स नाउ व्हेन ही वाज डूइंग दिस ऑपरेशन. सो ही वाज नॉट doing it, he was not diverting his attention towards anything. He just wanted to put his attention towards the operation only, so that he cannot ignore anything. And he did not listen to any of the words of Henna, and just he wanted to put his full attention towards that.